I will discuss in a program. Is it okay up to this point? Is it okay up to this point?
Yes, sir.
If I am talking about 2, 5, 8, 11, 14 and 17, suppose I have to elaborate this one, value of A is equal to 2. What about value of D? D is equal to 3. And what about nth term? Any idea about nth term? If I represent nth term as Tn, then what is the value? After calculating this one, you will find the answer of Tn is 3n minus 1. Am I audible? Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If I try to calculate T2, what is the answer? First insert n is equal to 2. 3 into 2, 6. 6 minus 1, answer is equal to 5. Similarly, I can calculate T. Suppose I have to apply this content inside programming. Okay. Let the title is arithmetic progression. Okay. First of all, what is the requirement? Int, input, enter first term. Is it okay? Is it okay? Enter first term. This one is the requirement. If I am going into the introduction part, three parts are required: A, D, and Tn. These are the three contents basically. After that, we can develop each and every term. Now, here I am writing A. Then after that, D is common difference. Int, input, I can write here, enter, common difference. Is it okay? Two contents are required. After that, how many number of terms you would like to int? Here I can write int, input, then count. Any doubt up to this point? Three variables are required. Is it okay? Getting my point or not? Is the point clear up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Last is equal to. What is the formula for that? A plus inside bracket n minus 1, then multiplied by b. Is that okay? This one is the last value. Now, if I have to print the values, suppose I am writing here series. Okay. I am writing here series, or you can write here TN. I think TN is the best word. TN. TN means nth term. A plus n minus 1 into D. Now, what about the series? If I am talking about series, inside list, first value, then last value with the jumping factor of D. This one is required. Now, what is the meaning of this? Inside series, what I have written? A, N, and D. If I am explaining this content, what is the meaning of this? Suppose I am entering A is equal to 2. Is that okay? And B is equal to T. And N is equal to 5. Is it okay? Suppose I am entering A is equal to 2, D is equal to 3, and N is equal to 5. Then what is the answer for TN? What is the answer for TN? It will be 2 plus inside bracket 5 minus 1 multiplied by 3. And answer is 2 plus 4 multiply 3. 4 multiply 3 is equal to 12. 2 plus 12 is equal to 14. Is it okay? Is it okay? Up to this point, any doubt? Suppose I am entering A is equal to 2, E is equal to 3, and N is equal to 5. Then EN can be calculated as 2 plus N minus 1 into D, means 5 minus 1 into D. And after that, what about list? Inside list, what I have written? A, comma, EN, comma, D. Now, what is the meaning of this? Okay. One more content is required here. I have to write a range. Like this. Now, what is the meaning of A, comma, TN, comma, D? It means it's 2, comma, 14, comma, 3. What is the meaning of this? First is starting value, and second one is the last value, and this one is the jumping factor. It means if first value is equal to 2, second value is 2 plus 3, that is 5. And then 5 plus 3, this one is 8, up to so on. Up to which number? Up to 14. Is it okay? Is it okay? Suppose I have to print this series. Okay. Suppose I am writing here print in double quote arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression. In next line, print. Suppose I am writing here series. Then execute the program. Enter first term. Suppose I am entering 2 here. And what about common difference? Suppose I am entering 3. And what about count? Suppose I am entering 5. Look at the values. Arithmetic progression is 2, 5, 8, and 11. 14 is not there. If I have to include 14, what I have to write? I have to write TN plus 1. If I am writing TN, it means TN is excluded because last value is excluded. We have already completed this one. If I am writing TN plus 1, I can include all the values. Now again, execute the program. If I am writing 2 here, then 3, then 5, How you can display all the values 2, 5, 8, 11, and 14. All the values are there. Is it okay up to this point? Any doubt up to this point?
Sir, count 5.
Count is equal to 5. This one is a number of values. Number of values. Suppose I am executing again. Okay. Suppose I am entering 11 here. Suppose I am entering 2 here and then 10. What will be the answer? 10 values are there and first value is 11. Second value is equal to 13. After that, 13 plus 2, 15 will be there. If I press enter, you can display 10 values. First value is 11. Then second value is 13, then 15, 17, 19, 21, 23, 25, 27, and 29. 10 values are there. Is it okay? You can display the series. Any doubt up to this point? Is it okay? Is it clear or not? Is the content clear or not?
Yes, sir, clear.
Okay. Suppose I have to find arithmetic mean also. And arithmetic mean. Now, what is the meaning of arithmetic mean? I have to add all the values, whatever the values entered by the user. And after that, I have to divide this sum by 10. In this case, whatever the count is there. For that, what I have to do? First of all, declare s is equal to 0. This one is one variable. To calculate sum of the series. Now, to calculate sum of the series, I have to apply for loop for I in range, whatever the length of the series. That range is required. For I in range and length of the series. Suppose I enter 22. It means the length should be 22. Means up to 22, I have to execute for loop. And after entering this content, s is equal to s plus. After that, I have already declared one list. Okay. This one is series. Series inside bracket, square bracket, I have to write I. What is the meaning of this? S is equal to S plus series I. If I have to, in first attempt, S is. And what about second step? S then series inside bracket 0. First value. What is the meaning of this? 0 plus. What about first value? In this case, first value is 11. It means I have to write 11 here. It means answer is equal to 11. Is it okay? Is it okay? In first step, answer is equal to 11. After that, s is equal to. Now, value of s is equal to 11 in the previous step. It means I have to write 11 here and second value series inside square bracket, I have to write 1. Now, what is the meaning of series inside square bracket 1? It means the second value is there. I have already completed in yesterday's lecture. Related to index of list. This one is the index of list. What I have to write? 11 plus 13 here. It means answer is 24. Is it okay? In this way, you can add all the contents. if I am writing here now, int sum of the series, suppose I am writing like this, sum of the series, comma, suppose I am writing s here. It means I can print the sum of the series. Now execute the program. Again, enter 11, then 2, then 10. You can display sum of the series. 11, 13, 15, up to so on, 29, you can display the sum of the series as 200. Is it okay? You can display sum of the series. After calculation of the sum of the series, what is required? I have to divide sum of the series by count so that I can find out arithmetic mean. For that, what I have to do? Let arithmetic mean is one variable, then s divided by length of the series, then print arithmetic mean is equal to comma am. Now again execute the program. Suppose I am entering 17, 5, and 21. Suppose these are the values. Look at the output. These are the values. These are the 21 items. First value is 17 and common difference is 5. 17, then 22, 27. You can display arithmetic progression up to 117. Means 21 terms are there. Then addition of all these terms, 1407. Then arithmetic mean of the series, 1407 divided by 21. Is it okay?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Can you explain the meaning of LEN series?
LEN stands for length. Length of the series. Series is one variable. Series is one variable. Inside that, all the contents of list are there. Nothing else. Series is one variable. And I am going to calculate length of that particular series. Means what's the length of series? This one is series. 11, 13, 15, 17. This one is series. I have to calculate length so that I can calculate arithmetic mean. Because length is required for that. What is the formula for arithmetic mean? What is for arithmetic mean? What is the formula? Arithmetic mean is equal to sum of all the items divided by number of items.
Okay, sir.
Sum of items divided by number of items. This one is the formula. To calculate number of items, I am using length. Is that okay? Length is one by default function inside Python. You can practice later by entering different kind of values. This one is one process of calculating AP series and arithmetic mean. Basically, this one is the application of a list inside programming. How we are using list inside Python. Is it okay? Should I continue with the next content?
Anji, sir.
Next content is geometric progression and geometric mean. This one, the second content. Now, what is the meaning of geometric progression? Any idea? What is the meaning of geometric progression?
So ratios comes equal.
Yes. Suppose I am writing the content of GP. Let the first value is P, and second is suppose 6. then third is 12, then 24, then 48, then 96, like this, and 192 up to so on. Is it okay? This one is geometric progression. Now we came to know that it's a geometric progression. First term is known as A, and after that common ratio, it's known as R. In this question, A is equal to 3 and common ratio is equal to 2. Now what is the meaning of common ratio? Second term divided by first term, or third term divided by second term, or fourth term divided by third term. Is it okay? Second divided by first, or third divided by second, or fourth divided by third, you can find out these values. Means R is a multiplier. If I'm going to explain this content in terms of standard value, then I can write AR, after that AR square, after that AR multiply R multiply R, like this. This one is a geometric progression. AR, AR square, AR cube. Basically, I have to display this content now. In the previous program, what I did, I have to display when the common difference is same, that is arithmetic progression. But in this program, what I am going to produce, I have to develop a series in which common ratio or ratio between two consecutive terms is same. Is it okay? Is the definition part clear so that we can proceed? Is the definition part clear? What about the nth term? Any idea? What is the answer for nth term? A, R, raised to power n minus 1. This one is the formula. A, R raised to power n minus 1. This one is the formula for nth term. I have to apply this content. First of all, entered content int input enter first term. Enter first term of GP. Or enter first term. Second one is R int input enter common ratio. Is it okay? Is it okay? You have to enter two terms. After that, count is required. Suppose I am entering n here, int input. Third value is count. Third requirement. After entering this content, what I have to do, I have to multiply all the terms. Now, print, first of all, GP is equal to, then for I in a range 0 to N. Now, what is the meaning of 0 to N? If I enter N is equal to 10, it means the loop will execute from 0 to 9. N values are there. Then I have to calculate the term is equal to A, then power function R comma I. what is the meaning of this term? Is equal to a multiply power r comma I. What is the meaning of this? It means if I am entering I is equal to zero. If I am explaining this content, for first value, I is equal to zero. Answer is only A, because R raised to power zero is equal to one. If I am entering I is equal to one, what is the meaning of this? A R. If I am entering I is equal to two, it means the answer is A R power two, A R square. Is it okay? These are the terms. After calculating these terms, I have to print all the values. Print term, then ending with, suppose I am writing comma here, ending with comma. Now execute this one so that we can check the execution or output. If I am entering 3 here, first term is equal to 3, common ratio is equal to 2, and count is equal to 7. Look at the value. 3, 6, 12, 24, 48, 96, and 192. Is it okay? You can display these terms. These are the terms. You can display the count according to your choice, or you can enter the value as per your requirement. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt up to this point? Is it clear? Now, what about geometric mean? Any idea about the formula of a geometric mean? Geometric mean is equal to product of all the items A multiply AR multiply AR square multiply AR cube up to so on. You have to multiply all the terms. Then you have to calculate power 1 divided by n, like this. Nth root of these terms. You have to calculate this one. It's known as geometric mean. You have to multiply all the terms, whatever the number of terms are here. After that, you have to calculate power 1 divided by a particular number. If I am calculating geometric mean of these terms, what I should do? I have to multiply all these numbers, then I have to calculate power 1 over 7 of this product. Is it okay? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, first of all, calculate the product of all the items. Suppose I am declaring one variable, product is equal to 1. Suppose this one is the starting point. Similar to sum is equal to 0. Because I have to add the values, that's why I have taken sum is equal to 0. In this case, I have to calculate product. It means the least value should be 1. If I am taking product is equal to 0, it means answer of all the product values is equal to 0. That's why I have taken product is equal to 1. Then for I in range 0 to n, then product is equal to product multiply a, and then a is equal to a multiply r. This one is the requirement, because each time I have to multiply the value by r, then print this value. Print, then product is equal to, I have to print this value. Now execute the program again. First term, suppose I am writing again, first term is equal to 3, then 2, then count is equal to 7. Look at this one. 3, 6, 12, 24, 48, 96, and 192. This one is the product of all the terms. This one. 4, 5, 8, 6, 4, 7, 1, 4, 2, 4. Now you can write here new line so that you can print the data in next line. Enter first term. This one is 3, then 2, then 7. Look at the output now. Metric progression. This one is GP, and this one is the product of all the terms. Is it okay? Now, after calculating product of the items, what I have to do? Metric mean is equal to power inside bracket product, comma, inside again bracket 1 divided by n. This one is required. Means I have to calculate nth root of this product. Nth root. It means I have to calculate power is equal to 1 over n of this product. Then print metric mean is equal to, I can print here VM. Now execute the program. Enter first term. Suppose I am entering again 3, 2, and 7. Look at this one. You can calculate geometric mean of all the items. This one is 23 point up to so on. Suppose I have to control this value, decimal points. Then simply I can write here round, then inside bracket goes up to 3 places of decimal, the answer is required. Round GM comma 3, geometric mean comma 3. Now execute the program. 3, 2, count is equal to 7. Now display the content. You can display 24 because 23.9 when rounded off, it will give 24. Is it clear up to this point? Is the content clear? Geometric progression and geometric mean with the application of lists or displaying content. Any doubt in this program?
No, sir.
Okay, one more content is pending, that is a harmonic progression. Harmonic progression and harmonic mean. What is the meaning of a harmonic progression? Any student who know about this content? Any idea about harmonic progression?
Sir, it is a progression formed by taking the reciprocals of
reciprocal
AP.
Of arithmetic progression. It's the reciprocal of arithmetic progression. If I am writing 1 divided by 2, the first term, and second is 1 divided by, suppose 5 is there, then 1 divided by, let us say 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 3, 8, and after that 1 divided by 11 will be there. Is it okay? This one is harmonic progression. And what about the mean of a harmonic progression? How to calculate mean of harmonic progression? Any idea? Suppose only 4 terms are there. I have to calculate mean of these terms. Then what to do?
Nth term of harmonic
progression. I can say हार्मोनिक मीन. हार्मोनिक मीन इज इन दिस केस 4 देन डिवाइडेड बाय इनसाइड ब्रैकेट 1/2 प्लस 1/5 प्लस 1/8 प्लस 1/11. Is it okay? If 4 terms are there, it means if n terms are there, then what will be the answer? Harmonic mean for n terms. I can write n divided by inside bracket 1 divided by first term plus 1 divided by second term plus 1 divided by term up to so on nth term inside bracket 1 divided by nth term. Is it okay? This one is the content we have to display inside this program. Should I continue? Up to this point, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Suppose I have to display these values. Then what to do? First of all, A is equal to int input. First term. After that, B is equal to, we have to apply the same content as that of AP series. Input. Then common difference. Common difference. And count n is equal to int. Input. And double quotes. Count. Is it okay? Values are required. Then last value, last or nth term, you can say last is a plus n minus 1 into d. To display all the contents, we have to write last is equal to last plus 1. Why last is equal to last plus 1? Because I have to display all the contents. Because if I am displaying up to last, it means it will display one value less than the last value. If I am writing last is equal to last plus 1, I can display all the values. Now list is equal to list, then range, and inside bracket A, comma, last, comma, D. These are the requirement of AP series. Before I continue this one, I have to display AP series because this one is reverse of AP series. Nothing else. List. Now execute the program. I will display a program, first program content 2, 3, 5. You can display all the content 2, 5, 8, 11, and 14. Is it okay? Up to this point. This one is arithmetic progression. 5 terms are there. Suppose I have to convert this these values into harmonic progression. Then what to do? Suppose I am creating one new variable, data, and this one is empty list. For I in range A, comma, last, comma D. This one is the requirement. And D1 is equal to str 1 then plus in double quotes divided sign then plus str I. This one is the requirement. Then data dot and inside bracket D1. देन प्रिंट डेटा, प्रिंट डेटा, आई एग्जीक्यूट दिस कंटेंट, लुक एट द आउटपुट. Now the data is in the form of 1 over 2, 1 over 5, 1 over 8, 1 over 11 and 1 over 14. This one is basically your harmonic progression. Is it okay? This one is harmonic progression. What I did, I convert the data into harmonic. Suppose I am writing here 3, then 7 and 11 is there. Look at this one. You can display the data in a harmonic form. 3, 10, 17, this one is arithmetic progression. And what about this content? Second one, 1 over 3, 1 over 10, 1 over 17, 1 over 24, up to so on, 1 divided by 73. It means you can display harmonic progression. Is it okay? Up to displaying of data. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Is the content clear?
Yes, sir.
Now the next content. How to calculate sum of this series? To calculate sum, S is equal to 0. This one is one variable. S is equal to 0. I have to declare one variable at the top. After that, addition is required for all the items. For I in range, then length of the list means whatever the number entered by the user, you have to count that number. That's why I am calculating inside this range. If you enter count is equal to 7, then length of the list is equal to 7. You can also enter n, 0 to n. You can apply that content also. And the next requirement is s is equal to s plus inside bracket 1 divided by list and inside square bracket I. Means first value, then second value, then third value, all the values are there. List I means list 0. Then list 1, list 2. Now, what is the meaning of list 0? Means first element. What is the meaning of list 1? Means second element. All the elements are there. And 1 divided by that element. It means reversing of the element, then keep on adding. Now, print. Sum of harmonic series. Harmonic series. And suppose I am using round here because this value will be in decimal. S, comma, T. Up to 3 points of decimal. Now execute the program again. Suppose I am writing 3 and 7. The 11 values are there. Look at the answer. Sum of the harmonic series. This one is 0.68. I am adding all the values because these values are in reducing order. First value is 1 over 3, then 1 over 10, 1 over 17, 1 over 24. These values are continuously in reduction order. Means all the values are reducing. That's why answer is equal to 0.68 means in decimal form, less than 1. Answer is there.
Sir, here S is not defined.
S is? What is the question?
Sorry, sir, it was my mistake.
It's defined. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Is it okay up to this point? After that, yes, I have to calculate a harmonic mean. Now, what about harmonic mean? This one is length of the list, then divided by sum of the series. This one is the content. Look at this one. Count, then divided by sum of the series. I have already calculated sum of the series. Now I have to divide this sum of the series with length, means length divided by sum of the series. Then I can display harmonic mean. Harmonic mean, then print, because I am writing HM. Is that okay? Because here we are writing S only without writing the round. Now check the output. First term, suppose I am writing 11. Common difference, suppose 3 is there and count is equal to 5. These are the values. 11, 14, 17, 20 and 23. This one is harmonic progression. 1 over 11, 1 over 14, 1 over 17, 1 over 20 and 1 over 23. Now sum of the harmonic series. This one is sum of harmonic series. And what about harmonic mean? This one is harmonic mean. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Is the content clear? Any doubt in all the programs? This one is, I'm going to repeat this content. This one is arithmetic progression and arithmetic mean. This one is the first program. I will share all the programs with you and kindly try at your own level. And this one is geometric progression and geometric mean. This one is the second program. And what about the third one? This one is harmonic progression and harmonic mean. What about any other series? Any idea about any other series? Is there only three type of series or any other type of series is also there? Any idea? Any other type of series? Do you know about patterns? Do you know about patterns?
Sir,
different type of patterns are there. One question I think generally asked inside your technical interview. Kindly try to design this pattern. And suppose stars are there or any other combination is there. I will try to solve that content in tomorrow's lecture. I will try to solve different type of patterns in Python. Suppose different type of stars are there. Suppose we have to design a diamond. Suppose I have to design in first line, 7 stars are there. In second line, 5 stars are there. Then again, 7 are there. Then 3 are there, like this. Suppose I have to design any kind of pattern. Then what to do? Or what type of pattern is possible? I will try to capture that content in tomorrow's lecture. Different type of patterns are also there. This one is series. That content is pattern. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
I will share this content in WhatsApp group. Any query from your side? Any query? Otherwise, I am going to close the lecture.
Sir, pattern ek bar dobara samjha do.
Pattern I will explain tomorrow, Gitanjali. I will explain in tomorrow's lecture, no issue.
Okay, sir.
I think some of the students are joining now. Message is already displayed inside WhatsApp group that today's class will be from 6 to 7. I will update about tomorrow's timing also. Is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Mohit, Mohit,
Amit, hello.
I think we have to close the session.
Okay, sir.
Okay, okay. Thank you, Mohit. Thank you, students. Thank you for joining.